Welcome to iJournal UC. In this video, we'll be doing 2020 bullet journal with me pages. There will be a total of 5 spreads. These spreads have their individual aesthetic journal with me videos as linked in the description box below. So if you are into a more peaceful journal with me video with aesthetic shots, hit there. This video is more of a rant video where I bring you through my thoughts while I create this spread and what else they could be used for. So the first spread here we have is the April and May video collaboration spread. It's something like a YouTube tracker but for video collaboration. So sometime in April and May, I decided to just have a compilation of collaboration. So I collaborated with 5 wonderful creators to create these videos. So it's some sort of like a goal, a journey. It's a journey to create different videos with different people. And this spread is more of like a mixed media journal kind of vibe. As you can see, it's not the traditional bullet journal with me spread where everything is straight and neat. I would call this spread a transition process for me to go into bullet journaling. It's more like a tracking, a transition process for me to go into bullet journaling while you are in the mixed media journey. So I printed my cover photos of these 5 videos. You can actually see the videos, all of these videos, as linked in the description box below. So 3 of them are journal with me videos and the other 2 are DIY videos. So those 2 DIY videos, one of it is how you can use washi tape and the other one is how you can pen pal. I incorporated some calligraphy which I've learned and I talked more about the calligraphy and how I learned calligraphy in the 5 ways which you can pen pal on a budget video. And I also incorporated some stamping or where I can stamp the dates. So here in Singapore, we stamp the dates per year, day and month. I know somewhere else in the world, y'all stamp dates per year, month and day. So where, how do you guys write your date? Day, month, year? Month, day, year? Or year, month, day? And voila, this is the first spread done. Do comment how you write your dates below. So the next spread is a moon spread, a lunar spread. So these 2 are watercolor skies. I tried to do a dark sky, but then it's like black is too black and then the blue is just blue. You know, it's like you can't really get the color right. Plus, it's the first time I'm using watercolor. So in this spread, I'm using my coffee stickers, my moonset coffee stickers, which you can get if you donate a coffee to me to help support this channel. So I shrunk all the lunar faces down into 7 faces. I duplicated 2 faces. And I made them into like the circle pointers for the days. Like, I don't know how to describe that, but as you can see, it is circle pointers for the day. So this spread is part of my June spread. So it's a June weekly spread. Right at the bottom, the white part is supposed to be clouds. That's why it's white, but it doesn't really look like cloud, but it kind of does the job, I think. Oh well. That's why these bullet journal spreads and bullet journal videos that I've been producing the past month is more of like a challenge to me. Since I am more used to doing mixed media journaling, junk journaling, and art journaling, doing this kind of spread is something out of the box for me, something out of the ordinary for me, and it is exciting and tiring. You know when you get out of your comfort zone, that's kind of tiring. Oh my, I'm ranting. Anyways, so next spread we have is the Yoga 2020 spread. I wanted a spread that features the whole year, where I can see the whole year of what I'm doing. And one of the things which I kept doing over and over throughout the year is yoga. So what's better than to have a yoga spread, a 365-day yoga spread? So this spread is where I feature the whole year, 12 months, yes, 12 months. So 6 months aside, and I can see how often I'm doing yoga at a certain month and how often I am not doing yoga, and how and should I increase the number of times that I exercise. So I am doing a stamping over here using an acrylic stamp and a acrylic block. I wanted to say glass block because it's see-through, but yes, it's an acrylic block. So I actually messed up a couple of times with the dates when I'm writing the draft, because it's like dates are not easy to write, okay? It's also being boring right now, but anyway, so yeah, so I decided to go for writing down the numbers instead of stamping them, because I realized that they might not have enough space if I stamp them, and it might take a long, long time. So writing down the numbers is better for me. Then I decided to do like a very, very simple banner into. Do not overcomplicate this page, because this page is something in which I would be going back again and again throughout the year. And throughout the year, I'm sure I have various thematic ideas and various different ideas which I would want to incorporate into this page. And sometimes maybe July, I will want like a emerald idea. And maybe come to August, I'm like, I am inspired by caves and I can't change it. So it's better to have like a minimalistic, simple spread for something which you keep going over and over again throughout the year. So I did some calligraphy on the months, and I do a shortcut, like a shortcut version on how to write the months. Yeah, like December, instead of December, I write this. You kind of get it, right? I hope you do. And I'm utilizing this color pencil which I've gotten ever since my childhood, so I'm not quite sure where are these color pencils from. And I tried to make it colorful, because although I want a minimalistic spread, I want it to be vibrant and bright and colorful and happy. I'm a happy person, so I like things to be happy. And here I'm just marking out the dates which I did yoga. So this is how you can do you can use a yoga spread or a 365-day spread using a simple highlighter, or you can draw circles, stars, whatever that makes you happy. Highlighter makes me happy, so I'm making it yellow. And this is the spread. I'm quite okay with how that spread turns out. It's not like insanely happy. It's just okay. It does the job. Okay, you know? So we're going on to this next spread. This is the Polariod spread. So unlike the other spreads, these spreads have two trackers. So the one on the left, which there is a huge Polaroid over there, I'm planning to do a music playlist tracker over there. And the one on the right is going to be a goals tracker. So I'm going to draw like the goals in which I am aiming to fulfill in this Polaroid. While the one on the left, the music tracker, I'm going to do like a music playlist for you. Mainly it's because after I wrote down the music which I listen to and I'm really into recently, you is the most used word in the songs. I don't know, maybe they are love songs. Well, you can check them out. And so that's the music playlist for you. That's why I named it playlist for you. And this is me outlining some of the goals. So like the more complicated ones and the more visible ones are the ones which I want to fulfill now, and more like prominent, like more eager to fulfill and more possible to. And the smaller ones are the ones which are not as eager to fulfill only when the time is right. I don't know. I'm confused about what I'm doing, and I use the color pencil as well. And yeah, this is my Polaroid spread. You can zoom in if you want, and you can actually see all of these photos of these spreads in my Instagram on iJournalUC. So this is like part of a clip from an aesthetic journal with me on this relationship tracker, relationship small happiness tracker spread. So because I realized that I didn't have enough footage from the overhead for this tracker, so I just decided to add that part. So if you want to see like the process between the painting and to the end, you can check the video out there. And that is the relationship tracker spread. And that is all of my spreads. I hope you do enjoy this and find that these spreads give you some inspiration. And thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Do remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And bye!